And that's why they say that you are unseen, O God.
तुम ही सबके प्राणपति हो, हमारे प्राणों के मालिक हो.
You are the owner, the Lord of our souls, our spirits.
किस विधि मिलूं दया में, हे परमेश्वर दया करो, मैं कैसे तुमसे मिलूं?
Oh Lord, have mercy upon us. How can I meet you with you?
क्योंकि मैं कुमति हूँ, मैं ignorant हूँ.
Lord, because I'm an ignorant person.
In darkness, अंधेरे में हूँ मैं.
And I live in darkness.
और जब परमेश्वर प्रकट हुआ तो प्रकट हो गया. इसीलिए भारत के वेदांत कहते हैं परमेश्वर प्रकट होगा.
And that's why the Vedas of Bharat says that God will be revealed.
Rig Veda में बहुत स्पष्ट भविष्यवाणी है.
And there's a clear prophecy in Rig Veda.
परमेश्वर जो सृष्टि करता है,
God who is a creator,
जब वो देह बनेगा, when he will become a flesh, body बनेगा, स्वरूप लेगा.
When he will take the form of a flesh,
परमेश्वर कभी स्वरूप नहीं लेता.
God never takes form.
परमेश्वर केवल वचन है.
Because God is a only word.
जब वो स्वरूप लेगा,
but when he takes form,
वो स्वरूप लेकर के मेमना बनेगा.
And he will take a form and will become a lamb.
प्रजापति भुवनेश्वर नाभि वो परमेश्वर जो सारे ब्रह्मांड का नाभि उत्तल है, सृष्टि करता है. He is the navel of the whole world.
The God who is the navel of the whole world.
प्रजापति भुवनेश्वर नाभि तत् प्रजापति यज्ञ शमेश वो प्रजापति देह लेगा.
And that God will take for human flesh.
और बलिदान करेगा.
He will take form and he will offer him a sacrifice.
अपने देह का बलिदान करेगा.
He will offer his own body as a sacrifice.
और बलिदान करने के लिए प्रजापति यज्ञ शमेश और प्रजापति जो सृष्टिकर्ता परमेश्वर है, जो संसार की भुवन नाभि है, वो मेष बनेगा, मतलब मेमना बनेगा.
एंड द क्रिएटर ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड प्रजापति विल बिकम दिस लैम, द सैक्रिफिशियल लैम.
और मेष बनकर के अपना बलिदान करेगा.
एंड ही विल बिकम द टेबल एंड ही हिमसेल्फ विल ऑफर हिमसेल्फ एज अ सैक्रिफाइस.
भारत के लोग जानते हैं जब तक परमेश्वर अपने को बलिदान न करे हमारा उद्धार नहीं हो सकता.
दैट्स व्हाई द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया नो दैट अंटिल गॉड ऑफर्स हिमसेल्फ एज अ सैक्रिफाइस वी कैनॉट रिसीव सैल्वेशन.
परमेश्वर आत्मा है जो शरीर में नहीं आएगा हमारे को मिलना नहीं हो सकता है.
एंड एज लॉन्ग एज दिस गॉड हू इज अ स्पिरिट डज नॉट टेक ह्यूमन फॉर्म एंड कम इन ह्यूमन फ्लैश मैन कैन कैनॉट रिसीव सैल्वेशन.
मैं दया में तुमसे है, मैं कुमती है, परमेश्वर दया करो, मैं कुमत मत अज्ञानी जो जिस अंधकार में रहता हूं, मैं कैसे तुमसे मिलूंगा?
लॉर्ड हैव मर्सी अपॉन अस, वी आर इग्नोरेंट ओ लॉर्ड, वी दोस हु लिव इन डार्कनेस, हाउ कैन वी एवर नो यू?
तो परमेश्वर ने इस प्रार्थना को सुना.
एंड गॉड हर्ड द क्राइज दिस प्रेयर.
ऋषियों की प्रार्थना को सुना.
गॉड हर्ड द प्रेयर्स ऑफ दिस ऋषिज.
वेदांत की प्रार्थना को सुना.
ही हर्ड द क्राइज द प्रेयर्स ऑफ वेदास.
और जो कुछ वेदांत में लिखा गया था, कहा गया था, दर्शन मिला था.
And all the revelation they had got, the vision they had seen through Vedas.
Prajapati ye ek bhuvaneshwar abhi prajapati jo sare bhuvan ka naval center hai wo prakat hoga.
And this prajapati, this god who is the center or the navel of the whole earth will be revealed, or he will reveal himself.
He will become body.
And then he will take the human for flesh, he will take the human form.
Aur wo memna banega.
And then he will become a lamb.
Aur memna ban karke apne aap ko baldan chada dega.
And he will become a lamb and he will offer himself as a sacrifice.
Wo khud hi to baldan ka memna hoga.
He himself will become a sacrificial lamb.
Aur wo hi baldan hoga.
He will become the sacrifice.
Aur wo hi baldan karne wala bhi hoga.
And he will be the person also who offers that sacrifice.
Aur us baldan mein se wo fir se apne aap ko prakat karega.
And through the sacrifice he will once again reveal himself.
Tatvam yatam moksha data aur wohi moksha ka dene wala banega.
And he will be the one who gives salvation.
Aur Yeshu Christ kaun hai?
And who is Jesus Christ?
Vedant ki bhavishyavani ki prarthana ka uttar hai.
He is the answer of the cries or the prayers of the Vedas.
जिस प्रार्थना को उसने किया था, वेदव्यास ऋषि ने किया था, उस प्रार्थना का उत्तर है.
एंड द वेदव्यास ऋषि द प्रेयर दैट ही प्रेड, जीसस केम एज़ अ रिप्लाई और आंसर टू हिज प्रेयर.
ईश पुत्रम सत्य ज्ञान परम्परम परागतम. जब परमेश्वर खुद ईश्वर पुत्र बनकर के प्रकट होगा.
एंड वेन गॉड हिमसेल्फ विल बिकम द सन ऑफ मैन एंड ही विल रिवील हिमसेल्फ.
सत्य ज्ञान अनंत ब्रह्म प्रकट होगा.
And when he will reveal himself as a truth for this entire creation.
इसीलिए वचन कहता है अज्ञान देव संसारो ज्ञान देव विमुच्यते. अज्ञान से भरा हुआ संसार जब तक ज्ञान प्रकट होगा तभी हम पाप से छूट जाएंगे.
And that's why this says that this world which is full of foolishness, which is lacking knowledge, when this wisdom or knowledge will be revealed, the world will be full of his wisdom.
तो उपनिषद में बहुत साफ लिखा हुआ है.
And it's clearly revealed in the Upanishad.
कोई परमेश्वर के जीवन को नहीं पा सकता.
Nobody can receive the life of this God.
हमारी सारी साधनाओं धर्म क्रियाओं के द्वारा भी अज्ञान में रहते हैं.
Through all our pilgrimage, through all our hard work, through all our sacrifices, we would not be able to find him.
जो कुछ भी हम करते हैं शरीर के द्वारा करते हैं.
Because whatever we do through our bodies.
और शरीर शापित है.
And the bodies, our bodies are cursed.
इस शरीर को छुड़ाने के लिए जब तक परमेश्वर शरीर में प्रकट नहीं होगा.
And to deliver this body from this curse, until God takes the human body, until takes the human flesh.
और हमारे पापों के पाप के बदले में जो शरीर पर दंडा गया उससे छूटने के लिए अपने शरीर को बलिदान नहीं करेगा.
And until he sacrifices his body and takes that punishment or that pain that we have upon our bodies,
तब तक हमारा छुटकारा नहीं हो सकता.
Until then, we cannot get deliverance.
और जिस दिन वो बलिदान करेगा,
the day he will offer himself as a sacrifice,
उस बलिदान में विश्वास करेंगे.
And when we believe upon that sacrifice,
हम उस बलिदान में एक हो जाएंगे.
Then we will become one in that sacrifice.
मैं परमेश्वर वचन बाइबल से नहीं कह रहा हूँ.
And this I am not saying from the word of God Bible.
मैं वेदांत से कह रहा हूँ.
This I am talking from the Vedas right now.
और जब वो प्रार्थना पूरी हो जाएगी,
when that prayer will be fulfilled,
तब हम मोक्ष पा लेंगे.
Then we will receive salvation.
इसीलिए परमेश्वर ने उपाय किया.
That's why God made a way.
योग तत्व उपनिषद की प्रार्थना को पूरा किया.
And God fulfilled or listened to the prayers of the Upanishad.
अज्ञान देवो संसारो ज्ञान देव मुचिते. जब ज्ञान का जो आधार है, जो ज्ञान खुद है, वो प्रकट होगा.
And he himself who is the source of knowledge or wisdom, who himself is knowledge or wisdom, when he will reveal himself,
उस ज्ञान को पाने के द्वारा, उसके जीवन को पाने के द्वारा,
by receiving that knowledge of him, by receiving his life in us,
ज्ञान देव विमुचित है, हम अज्ञान से छूट जाएंगे.
Then we will get rid of ignorance.
परमेश्वर को न जानने के ज्ञान से छूट जाएंगे.
We will get off that ignorance of knowing, not knowing God.
परमेश्वर का जीवन बन जाएगा.
Then God will become our life.
पूरे भारतीय दर्शन के अंदर 3000 पहचान है परमेश्वर की.
In all Indian philosophy there are about 3000 knowledge or information about God.
The attributes of God are being revealed. परमेश्वर की पहचान है, प्रकट हुई है.
And the attributes of God have been revealed.
परमेश्वर कैसा होगा?
How will God be?
उसके कार्य कैसे होंगे?
How will his works be?
वो सब reciprocate कर रहे थे परमेश्वर को.
And all these things were reciprocating God.
ढूंढ रहे थे परमेश्वर को.
They were seeking God.
और परमेश्वर के वचन में सारी पहचानें पूरी हो गईं.
And all these attributes of God were fulfilled in His Word.
सारी पहचानें प्रभु यीशु मसीह में इकट्ठी हो गईं.
All these knowledge and all these attributes were fulfilled in the form of Lord Jesus Christ.
Chapter 1, verse 15. He is the image of the invisible God,
yes.
The firstborn of all creation. For by him all things were created that are in heaven and that are on earth.
For all the things that are on this earth, are visible and invisible, everything was made by him and for him. Until now, what was invisible? That's why this is the prayer now in India.
Unseen God.
You are an unseen God. We are not able to know you. I am an ignorant person. How would I know you? You reveal yourself to us. Oh, the God of this earth reveal yourself to us. And he revealed himself to us. Whatever we created went to him. And then this unseen God was revealed. Who is Jesus Christ?
For by him all things were created that are in heaven and on earth, are visible and invisible, from the thrones or dominions or principalities or powers.
All the powers of earth is dominion, whatever it might be, is all of us through him.
All things were created through him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things consist.
That God
living is
us. Nobody has ever said this thing authoritatively. Lord of the great people who have heard,
man, beauty is with.
Lord of great
children,
great
incarnations
to place,
no answer,
and the people of the great places and people believe that these are the gods, the vices, the authorities, all kinds of people that believe. But nobody ever claimed that I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one ever said that I am the image of the unseen God. No one ever claimed that those who have seen me have seen the Father. So he who has a son has got life, has got God. And that's why God was revealed as an answer to the cries and prayers of the rishis. That's the one thing that I want to say. And it's an eternal God, the living God, was seeking Israel. And Israel means God's chosen people. Amongst whom God wanted to dwell. God must do his works. He was seeing Israel. But what were the people of India doing? People of India, the Rishi of India were seeking God. And in Israel, you can see God was seeking Israel, God was seeking man. But in India, God was not seeking man, men were seeking God. That's why they were crying out and they were shouting and they were screaming and they were wanting to know the God. But Israel was not calling upon God. But God was calling them. But India was calling upon God. That's why Jesus Christ is the call or the cry of India. That's why Jesus Christ, God heard the cry of Indian people and came as an answer. That's why Jesus Christ is the fulfillment of all of the gospel of all the things of India. And all the gospels that have been there in India before, they were there to prepare the way for the Lord. And in all of them, there was this hunger for the truth. No one ever said that I have found the truth. But I want to know to see this truth. But when they did not find the truth, what did they do? When they could not find this truth, they made idols. And they made their own idols, They made their own plans. And they made places for houses of worship. And they turned one God into different forms. Does God dwell in different forms? Look what God in the Word of God says. What kind of place of worship are you going to build for God? Acts of the Apostles in chapter 7. I can say in my own
word.
Does God dwell in the places built by human hands? No, God does not dwell in such places. But God wants to dwell in our lives. The Word of God says, you are the temple of the Holy Spirit. You are His fragrance. God wants to dwell in your life. And God fulfilled the answer, the prayers of the rich of India. This God was eternal. He was real. He revealed the love of the Father.
Constrained by the love of God, God came into flesh.
Or brings the English program for nation What's the first thing that he did? What's the first knowledge or recognition of God in India? As I have told before, who is God? And this eternal God is the Word. And what does the Word say? And in John chapter 1. And we will look at the scriptures really quick. If the Gospel of John 1:1.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
And the Word was God.
And the Word was God. Our Word is God. And this Word of God has been there from eternity past. This is what the Vedas say also. That God is Word. And when God takes a human form, then the Word will take human flesh. And the Word became flesh. Chapter 1, verse 2.
And in Him was life, and the life was the light of men.
And God became flesh.
And this Word became life for our lives.
All things were made through Him, and without Him nothing was made that was made.
whatever the things were made on this earth, they were made by Him. Who is Jesus Christ? He is the Creator. And He is the Creator. God is our Creator. And in the philosophers of India and the Vedas, they say that God is light. You are not art Kabbalah. What witness or what testimony did you
give?
I am the light of the world. And those who follow me will never walk in darkness. That's why the word says we are all seeking Him, seeking God. And very quickly I want to for you to see this. Whatever the knowledge of God is there in the Vedas, and wherever we find the philosophies of the world where they are seeking God, all those things were fulfilled in the form of Jesus Christ. These cards from John 28.
Thomas answered and said to him, My Lord and my God.
Who is he?
Prabhu Parameshwar.
He is the Lord God. Where else do you find Lord God? And he is the full incarnation of God. When he comes in his flesh, he will be the full incarnation of God. And the Gospel according to John chapter 1,
verse 14, 15, 16.
So the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
He is the perfect incarnation of the King God.
He is the perfect incarnation of God, the image of God. This is what we saw in Colossians. He is the full God.
He is the perfect image of the King God.
And why do we say that? It's for that He makes everything in Him one. But He is the head and strength of our everyone. Everything was made by Him, for Him, and in Him.
Chapter 1, verse 16.
Created that are in heaven, that are on earth, visible and invisible.
That's why God is complete. And that's the word of God. That God takes human form. That if it takes human flesh or form, that's time God will be revealed before people. And people will be able to see His realization. And that's why the Rishis have this prayer in Vedas. Lord, I'm going to see you how are you going to get saved. He became our vision. And that's why the word of God says that He did. He took it. He became incarnation. He took human form.
He incarnated as a man.
And He came amongst us. And we saw His glory as the God's glory. And then He won victory over death. Or that's what God known as the overcomer of death. And we see that the Gospel of John, verse 12, chapter 20, and the whole 20 chapter says that He won victory over death. And in the first Corinthians chapter 1, that He created the ocean, it says that He became the overcomer of everything. And who is God?
He is a just Shashvat Purush.
He is eternal man. And that Shashvat Purush means He is from eternity past. And He will live before eternity also. And John, the last part of John, verse 4, verse 19. Look at it quickly. John 4, 19.
The woman said to Him, Sir, I perceive that You are a prophet. Our fathers worshipped on this mountain, and You do say that Jerusalem is the place where one ought to worship.
Who is this Christ Jesus? All the prophets testify about him. He is the one who is there from eternity past. What is his own identity?
I came forth from the Father and have come into the world. Again, I leave the world and go to the Father.
He is a living Christ.
He is the eternal God. And God was revealed through him. All the prayers of Vedas have been fulfilled through him. And if I had time, I would tell you that there were 3,000 information or revelation about God and Vedas that have been fulfilled in Christ Jesus. And God is the one who is omniscient, who knows everything. And God reveals himself in the form of mankind. And the God's name is the God of Shepherd.
And he is the Shepherd.
And the God's name is the body of sacrifice. That's why Jesus Christ became the body for sacrifice. And the name of God is the Word in India. And through his Word, He became the light. And God reveals himself to us. And Jesus Christ, God, took form a man in the form of Jesus Christ. In John 14, he says, those who have seen Jesus says, those who have seen me have seen the Father. Look at my words, these words are not mine, but these are the words of my Father. And you believe that I am the Father is in me. Before this, nobody had ever made a statement like this. Nobody has ever said that I am the door. Nobody has ever said that without me, nobody can go to the Father. Nobody has ever said before this that I am the rivers of living water. Nobody has ever said that I am the resurrection and the life. And every time with much authority, Jesus said, I am. And who is God? And God had given his identity in the beginning. What did he give himself as to Moses? And I am the one who is there from eternity past.
I am.
Jesus Christ also says, I am. I am the way, the truth, and the life. And Jesus said, without me, nobody can go to the Father. And I am the Father, and the Father is in me. And this prayer is just like the Son is in the Father. This is the realization. This is what was sought by the people of India. People of all the world were seeking him. And all those prayers have been fulfilled in Jesus Christ. That's why the word says that from ancient times God has been speaking to mankind. Hebrews chapter 1. Hebrews 1, 1 and 2.
From the time past.
Hebrews chapter 1, 1 and 2.
God, who at various times and in various places spoke in time past to the fathers by the prophets, has in these last days spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things.
the ancient times where God used to speak. And all those philosophies in Vedas, all the revelation in there, Vedas were received by God. And then I revealed myself, how will I be revealed? And those things were fulfilled in the Bible. And when Jesus was revealed, those things were exactly in Him like they were said. In Vedas, there are 3,000 identities of God. And from the ancient part, the past, God has been talking about attributes like this. And from ancient times, people were seeking God again. When they could not find this living God, they turned this God into stones, into idols. And God is not able to see the living through our eyes. Until it becomes our identity. Until it becomes the testimony of the witness of our lives. Until our God lives and moves and has his being to us. They will still see, people will still see this God in temples, in idols, in stones. And God, people will still make God denominations. Some people will become Catholics, some people will become Protestants. They are away from the glory of God. And no Vedas, no Catholics, no Protestants can become a part of the kingdom of God. But the ones that have the life of Son in him or her, in him they or her they have the life of God. And who doesn't have the Son of God, and even now they are cursed from God.
They are Jewish condemnation.
That's why God was revealed. And the Rishis of India were crying out. You are my father, you are my mother, you are my friend, you are my everything. You are my everything. You are my great, mighty God.
Father of fathers.
In the Vedas in India, it says that when God reveals himself, he will reveal himself, father of fathers. And the Vedas says that this world is untrue and lies. And whatever you will receive on this earth, all those things are in vain. That's why God's servant Solomon said like this. And I have received everything I wanted under the face, under the sun. And he said, after receiving all these things, what did I receive? Everything was in vain, everything was vanity, everything was a lie. Just like holding air in your arm, yes. You will not be able to hold anything in this world. If these things could be found on earth, the Rishis of India would have been able to receive all these things much before. And Rishis or the hermits of India have sought his God. And
only God is only considerable.
God is only one who is considerable.
Whatever you want in the world, only you want the living God.
Or जो कुछ इस संसार में चाहिए वो सिर्फ परमेश्वर जी के परमेश्वर में ही मिल सकता है. और whatever else you see, there's no use. That's why the Rishis said, whatever you see on this earth, those are perishable, you will lose all of them, you will not be able to keep any one of them. But when you receive the life of God, you will have received everything. And that's why God fulfilled all these things in the form of Jesus Christ. And this was the seeking of my life or the search of my life. When I was 4 years of age, I came to know that God loves me. My mom was crying for this. And she was crying because God's love was making her weep and cry. I asked, Mom, why are you crying? And she said, God's love is making me cry. Then I said, what kind of God is this who makes you cry? And I didn't know that time what kind of God he is. I asked, Mom, who is God? Then she said, your father. Then I said, leave my father, I should be pleased to my father. And from then on, the search for God continued in my life. And just like Brother Kiram said, I kept on seeking him everywhere. There's a poem I had written a long time back that I want to remind you.
I want to quote to
Hey Kavi.
This is true word that I was seeking you from the dead, from eternity to eternity.
ये तो सच है परिश्रम के आने काल से मैं तुझे ढूंढता आया हूँ.
ये तो सच है तुझे ढूंढता रहा है जीवन धर्म धर्म से पर्वत की रेती ऐसी मैं तुझे के दर्द को नहीं पाया. कल इस संसार के अंदर the body of sin, the burden of sin so that I was unable to reach you your throne. ये भी ढूंढती.
This was my search.
तो परमेश्वर में ढूंढ रहा
था. I was seeking God.
मैंने विराम समय ढूंढा.
I saw him in the wilderness.
मुझे पहचान तो मिली.
I had some knowledge of him.
But उस पर्सन के लिए मेरा फ्रेंड ढूंढ नहीं मिला.
But I was seeking personification, his realization.
पिता मिलता है तो बच्चा भाग के फिर घर में चला जाता है.
When the father is found, the child runs to the father. And when they see the love of a mother, the child runs to the mother, he's able to drink milk from her, he's able to embrace her. But I was saying that I'm seeking you every time, but how come you're not found by me? I saw you in Islam. Wherever it was that, wherever God was taught, I tried to see him in all those places. But I did not find him. I received his knowledge. I revived the revelation of his
finished.
But I could not find him near me as my own father. The one I could listen to, the one I could hear from him, the one I could understand and realize. Then God started
working.
When I used to study in college, I opened my book one day to study how and then it was written the Sermon on the Mount. Then I thought the Sermon on the Mount is just to be a message, but what kind of message will you on the
Mount?
Then I started reading the book. And in that book there was a mention about Jesus Christ. And I did not have a good impression about Jesus Christ. Because I thought Jesus Christ was a part of Christianity. That's why I did not want to see him. That's why I left reading that book that spoke about Jesus. But this book had impressed Gandhiji a lot. I was quite impressed by the life of Gandhi because I used to live with him when I was a child.
My knowledge was the best in the world.
And then I thought the book that has to impress Gandhiji, I should or inspire Gandhiji, I should read that book. And I was reading the book. Suddenly I heard the voice from somebody. I am the one whom you have been seeking since your childhood. And the room where I was sitting and reading the Sermon on the Mount got filled with a strange
light.
A light of such kind that I have never seen in my entire life. It always seemed like God had been revealed there. And then when I was reading the Sermon on the Mount, I knew that such kind of life cannot be lived by the people. It has to be the life of God alone. First time in my life I heard that I am the one that who we have been searching. Then I started seeking him in Christianity. I sought him in the Bible. I started seeking him in the churches. I was seeking his life. Where did I find his Sermon on the Mount? Where did I find his life? Where did I find the life of the Almighty God? Where did I find his loving Father? Who will deliver me from my sin, from my sorrow? I did not find this in the Christians or in the churches. I was looking for, seeking for the living God who was revealed through Jesus Christ. And then I saw the life. I saw Christ, the life of God, in my own wife.
She was a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ.
वो यीशु मसीह की अनुयायी थी.
आज भी प्रभु यूनी लास्ट है.
Even today she is a disciple of Jesus.
Even today प्रभु यूनी लास्ट है.
In her life I see Jesus walking and moving.
ये वचन ले रही हूँ मैं भी.
That's how the word became flesh for me through her.
मतलब मैंने छुआ प्रभु यीशु मसीह को.
Then I touched Jesus.
उसके प्रेम को पाया.
I received his love.
मतलब मैंने पहली बार उसके दर्शन में पाया. फिर दोबारा पाया.
And for the second time I got his vision.
मैं बार बार भाग रहा था.
Again and again I was running away from him. And in 1972 in the afternoon he appeared to me as in a movie. He again surrounded me. And he said, how long are you going to run away from me? I love you. Look at my body. I became a sacrifice for you. I saw the blood oozing out of his body. I saw his pierced hands. And then I saw his head which was pierced with the crown which was his head. And then I shouted and said, and when I saw him, my life became full of sin. Then I realized how big a sinner I was. I was seeking you, but I was full of sin. And I didn't realize just how many sins I had committed in my life. For the first time in my life, just like a document is shown, my sins were shown as in a movie. And from the time I received knowledge, that is from 4 years of age onwards, I started committing sin. And then I realized that day that when I was 4 years of age, I had deceived my own mom. And as a small child, I had lied to my mom. And when I was living on this earth, how many sins I had committed. And when I didn't even know how cruel the king of Bruta. When I used to do business, when I was business, I used to deceive people a lot. I wanted to make my business successful through hook and crook. I never realized just how big a sinner I was. Then I saw the great life of God. I look at his love. And then after looking at God, I look at myself, I thought I saw how big a wicked person or unworthy person I was. God, he loves sinners like me. Then God said, I have loved you from eternity past. I still love you today. Will you come to me? Then I surrendered my life to him. And the heart cry, my heart cry, which was the heart cry of the rishi, or the hermit also, was fulfilled. He drew me out of the darkness of sin. And in Christ Jesus, I found Father's
eye.
And all the sin and darkness were removed from my life. And my life or my body, which was full of the sin of the world, was removed and God filled with the life of God. And dear ones, I want to tell you, I have attained the highest of life. I have been to high places. And God has shown me every high place of this world. And from college, I went to the movie industry. I had no training.
No acting, no direction.
No training to act or to direct movies.
But it is available there.
But those are only for me. And the big directors of the big movie directors of India started offering me movies. And everything got me. And from movie industry, God took me into business.
I guess the case of Mandy Ratton Villas.
I earned a lot of money. I set up a lot of industries. And from there, God took me to politics. A body of Achi Padre.
He asked me to go.
But where is peace to be seen? and the lot of worship places are there, places, houses of prayer are there all over the world. Churches are there, temples are there. They all talk about God. But how come the life of God is not there? How come God is not able to move and actually be through them? That is our ignorance. And this ignorance is the great one of the biggest sins.
This is the biggest sin, not knowing God, is the biggest sin of the world.
परमेश्वर को ना जाने जो सबसे बड़ा पाप है.
जाने वालों के जीवन में खुले
हैं. And you know God is to become one in His life.
जीवन में प्रकट होते हैं. जीवन में प्रकट हो जाए.
That His life will be revealed in us.
यह मसीह जीवन संभव है.
This is only possible in Christ Jesus.
जो भी लोग हमें जितने लोग चाहते हैं परमेश्वर के जीवन पा पाए.
And all those who are here tonight, I want that you should know this God.
आप जानते ही होंगे.
You might be a Christian from your childhood. You might be a Hindu who goes to the temples. You might have heard of Badrinath Ashram and you might be taking a bath in the river. You might have been taking bath in the Ganges River. And you might have even gone to Jerusalem. You might have celebrated Christmas or Janmashtami. But you cannot find God through any of these things.
जब तक आपके जीवन में परमिशन नहीं आ
जाता दिस बार पास की लड़ाई
इसलिए आपको विश्वास के बाद जो भी दिया उसने आपको सामना पड़ेगा उसका
एंड ऑल दैट यू हैव टू सरेंडर योर सेल्फ विद ऑल दैट यू हैव टू गिव बाय फेथ
ये बदला है परमेश्वर जब देव बनेगा और देव को प्राप्त कर लेंगे तब परमेश्वर जीवन को मिल जाएगा
एंड गॉड वाज टू कम फ्लैश लेट यू सी दिस फ्लैश इन बॉडी देन गॉड विल बिकम
अ मैन आपको आने के लिए परमेश्वर ने क्या किया
व्हाट डिड गॉड डू टू रिसीव अस हियर अस What did God do to come to us?
प्रजापति भुवनेश्वर के प्रजापति ये ये हुए परमेश्वर शरीर बना
God took body human body
और शरीर बनकर हमारे बीच में आया
He took a human form and he came amongst us that we might receive his body. So it's necessary to receive his body, we have to surrender our body to him. And this life which is full of sin and selfishness, and this life that is full of sin, and yet even people that we are straying away in darkness, we say that we know God, but God is not found in our lives. We do not have the knowledge of God in our lives, or identity of God in our lives. We are not able to take a person who is in darkness to light. And Jesus said, after I am this world, those who know me will not walk in darkness. Jesus said, you are the light of this world. And you will be able to reflect the light or be a light to those who are in darkness. Do we want today that they should receive the light of God? Our biggest problem is to receive this God. This God cannot be found in temples or in churches.
In life of Jesus
Christ,
only we can find that God.
So, Yeshu Masih mein hi
hame parameshwar ka
paas karte hain. He who has the Son has the power. So, if we want to find this great God or great Father, we have to come to Him through Jesus Christ. Just like the Rishis were crying out, we should surrender ourselves before
Him. Permission for that.
Oh God, have mercy upon us.
हम कुछ भी हम तेरा जीवन हमारे पास
नहीं है तेरा
जीवन हमें चाहिए
We want your life in us.
सारी मनुष्य जाति इस जीवन को देखना चाहती है
All the mankind wants to see your life.
ये पृथ्वी और सृष्टि करा रही है परमेश्वर के पुत्रों से प्रकट होने की
And this whole eternity, the earth, this creation is groaning for the Son of Man to be
revealed. देखना चाहते हैं परमेश्वर के बेटा बेटी की उत्पत्ति से
And angels are coming to the horizon and I'm wanting to see God's sons and daughters or children upon this earth. Will we become the sons and daughters of God? Are you ready tonight? He says, if you ask, then I'll give you. God is merciful and gracious.
अपने पाप को सुधार करेंगे
दिल्ली दिल्ली
परमेश्वर से बातें तो करते हैं
basically, Lord God, we talk about you. We worship you. But your life is not to be found in us. Today we commit our lives to you. Oh Lord, you come to our lives. You take us to yourself. We may be removed, but you may be revealed through us. Let's bow our heads in prayer. In prayer, let's bow our heads. Let's bow our heads in reverence. Our hearts prepare. Are we able to open our hearts before the Lord? Are we able to say, Lord, in your presence we are unworthy people? Your life is not before us. Your identity is not revealed through us. But you are gracious and merciful. And you have said that your grace is sufficient for us. That's why you came to this world, that you may dwell among us. Lord, no matter however I am or whatever I am, I come before you. Lord, block out all my transgressions. Whatever sins have been committed to this body, forgive those sins. That body that has been sacrificed for us. That blood that was shed for me. Give me that life, O Lord. Give me the life of that blood. And the body that was shed for me. But Lord, I offer my body as a living sacrifice unto you.
I come to your cross.
मैं आपके क्रूस के पास आता हूँ.
अपने जीवन को मुझे सौंप
देता हूँ.
मुझे नया मनुष्य
बना दे.
एक रोग ऐसा कर मैं सब कुछ नया हो जाऊँ.
And Lord, do that I will get many wish, that everything will become new. Make me your witness. Make me your light. Make me your ambassador. Make me your fragrance. Through my life, that your fragrance will reveal. Lord, have mercy and grace. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. If you have any questions to ask, if you have any doubt,
we will offer to you.
Any kind of doubt you have?
I'm here to answer.
May I come up to you? You can ask. You can
ask. You can ask. You can ask. You can ask. You can ask. The cards are here.
And you can ask your questions now, you can ask tomorrow, you can ask the day after. You can write, there are cards for you, you can write your questions. If you have any questions for me, I will have the
answers.
Before you leave this place, the brothers to the people of ours,
what are you going to
ask? And you can write your suggestions. If you have any questions, you can ask them. And in God's grace, I will be able to ask those questions for you.
What do you
do? Do in our marriage, may the Lord help us. God has shown grace upon us. And by His grace, He has brought you here. The same grace, He will take you back home safely. This is my prayer that God's life may be living through you. And the people of this world are seeking the life of His God. If only you become that light of God that the world is seeking for. May the Lord Jesus Christ move and has been through you. May the people see God's light in the works. And let the people say, I have seen God for them. And then the peace of God that passes all understanding will dwell among mankind. And those who bless you, they will stand as God. And God's grace and love will be spread all over the world for you. And this is the cry of my inner heart, from the depth of my heart, that you become the light of God. This is the calling of God for each and every one of us.
हमारी प्रार्थना है परमेश्वर के कॉलिंग को आप सुनने में सफलता है.
This is my prayer, Lord, that you will listen to us calling and draw you to Him.
परमेश्वर के हाथों में आप सफल हो.
And I surrender you all into the hands of God.
परमेश्वर की उपस्थिति, परमेश्वर करुणा पे आप सफल
हो. In God's presence, God's mercy, God's grace be with you.
Thank you for coming.
आने के लिए धन्यवाद.
God bless you. And
परमेश्वर
just testimony of the Lord.
परमेश्वर आपको अपना गवाह बनाए.